Lord shall locate you, the Lord shall bless you in Jesus' name. I want to talk to somebody. I said, the Lord shall find you.
Amen.
The Lord shall locate you.
Amen.
The Lord shall bless you.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. So the topic we are discussing today is one with God. One with God. There's a slang that says one with God is his majority. And in the village where I came from, they said one with God is even more than majority. One with God is more than the majority. One with God. One with God means somebody with God. We're talking about one with God. That one with God puts everybody aside. He talks to you directly. You and your issue. You and your situation. You and your world. Amen. You and your circumstances. Let us say one with God.
One with God.
Father, I pray you will open the eyes of your people to see. You give them the understanding to know all that you prepare for them today. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
As we are sitting down in the church today, everybody, we are like different world. Everybody is a world of its own. There is no way you can compare two lives together. What you are passing through in some area may be better than what I'm passing through. In another area, mine might be better than what you are passing through. And the kind of environment that you are exposed to, what is actually going on, may not, even if you are telling me, I may not understand. And when I'm telling you mine, you may not even know. You may say, I hear you, but you may not understand. Because everyone is like a world of its own. Something going on in your mind, something going on around you. Now, when I say one with God, in that your state of mind, in that your world, in the marketplace of your life, where there are buys and sellings, where there are emotional tosses, ups and downs, where there are many and lack, where there are laxity, where there are abundance, where there are pressuring needs, where there are issues that seems like there is nobody. I'm saying you now, I'm talking about you, with God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And I'm not making a mistake, I'm not saying we with God. I say you with God, one with God. Let us say one with God.
One with God.
And the beauty of Christianity is that you don't need to have an answer to all the questions. Amen?
Amen.
Everybody has one question or the other that is asking. You're asking why. You're having an issue that you feel like you should have an answer to. But that answer is not coming forth. Okay? Now, the beauty of it is that because you are a Christian, you don't need to have an answer to all the questions. You know what is the most important thing? Is that once you have God, you have what it takes to answer that question that arises in your life. Sometimes as a person, you feel lonely. You feel like you are all alone. Okay? Sometimes you feel like you don't have friends. How many of us have been stabbed by a friend before? I'm not talking about bringing a knife. Okay? English version, when they said stab you behind, means that they turn their back against you when you have depended on them.
Betrayed.
Okay?
Huh?
Betrayed. Okay? How many of us have been betrayed in the past? Okay? Almost everybody. You've been stabbed, you've trusted a friend, and the friend turns around and they left you in limbo. You are all alone. And you feel like they know all your secrets and they can use it against you at any moment. Or even you have promised each other and they are no more dear. Okay? You feel alone, you feel lonely. And also sometimes things come up in our life that we feel like we are telling people they don't understand. For especially the young ones, you feel like there are issues you are telling your parents, they just don't understand it. Or you the parents, you are telling the kids. You know the children, they feel like they know all things. You tell them so much, but they feel like you are old school. You don't know what is going on. And you know that you are trying to save them from dangers, from making big mistakes. Okay? And you feel like all that is going on around you, you are all alone, nobody else understands. And you feel like there are things coming up here and there, And you expect people, for especially when you are not a kind of person that ignore other people. When they have issues, when situation arise, you are there for them. And you feel like when you are passing through yours, you should have them. And you look around, you are all alone. Not even a phone call. Or even you call, they ignore your call. You send a text message, it's like your message, it bounces back and says this number has been blocked. And if you have found yourself in a situation that you feel like you have tried many things, but you have come to a conclusion that all hope is lost, no solution. And I am saying to the children of the Lord, this might have brought you to a point of being alone. But I ask you, are you all alone indeed? The answer is no. You might feel like you are all by yourself, but I tell you, God is with you. Somebody say, God is with me.
God is with me.
In things that are running in your blood, in the heat of the day, and the heat of the persecutions, afflictions, lack, okay, abuse, lost, and all sort of things, I am saying you are not all alone if you have God. Amen? Because if we say alone with God, that means you better have that God, right? So you have, at least you have a companion. Now I'm saying, if you have God, you are not alone.
Amen.
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 Amen. I want us to go to the book of Jeremiah chapter 30. Jeremiah 30, verse 8 and 9. Please let us read. For it shall come to pass in that day, says the Lord of hosts, that I will break his yoke from your neck and will burst your bonds. Foreigners shall no more enslave them, but they shall serve the Lord their God, and David their king, whom I will raise up for them. Amen. This is the word of the Lord. He said, that day will come, I will break the yoke off their neck. I will break the yoke off their neck. Do you know what they call yoke? A yoke is what the farmers put on a horse or a cow, and they tie it with a kind of tool. When that cow is moving, is dragging that thing, but you know the yoke is the controlling factor. When they turn that thing, it forces the neck of that animal to turn. So they are using it as a steering to drive that animal. So now, God said, whatsoever that might have been on you as a person, okay, a day is coming that I will break the yoke. Listen, if that wood, the place on the neck of the animal is broken, how else will you be able to control the animal? You have to look for another means. And nothing works more than the yoke itself. So the yoke is broken, you are free. God said, it's coming. Even though it's coming, may not be instant. Okay? You may be feeling the pressure right now. You may be feeling the pressure right now. You may be experiencing it right now. And it feels like today is the end of the world. Are you listening? It is not the end of the world.
Amen.
It is not the end of the world. God said he will break that yoke.
Amen.
You don't need that to your brother. You don't need that to your uncle. That your best friend, you don't need it. You don't need her. When God is ready, he breaks the yokes. You will be free.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So, the world may be against you. If God is with you, you are okay. If God is with you, the future is bright. If God is with you, you are going to laugh again.
Amen.
If God is with you, you are going to see your dreams come to fulfillment.
Amen.
Because one with God is more than majority. Amen.
Amen.
Now, if you have this God, what are you supposed to do? I will still explain a little bit further in the book of Jeremiah. But if you have this God, what are you supposed to do? I ask you a question. Do you have relationship with that God? Do you know how many people die as paupers, but they are supposed to be rich? If you have something, you don't know you have it. you may still be suffering for that thing that you have. If God is on your side and you are not making the benefit of that God, you will not enjoy that God. Are you making the benefit of that God that you have? Don't use theory, use practical. Do you call unto God upon that issue that you are passing through? Because you are already with God. You don't need other people. As I have said, do you enjoy the benefit of that God that you have? Have you called God over that issue that you are passing through? I'm asking you a question. Have you called God? Have you invited God into the issue? If you are a child of God, let there be a solution. Ask the Lord to come into the issue. You have God. You have prayer. Why don't you pray and ask God to come into the issue? Hallelujah. I know what I'm talking about because we Christians, we don't make use of God that we have. I'm not saying you don't pray. But have you brought that issue to God? I'm not talking about, you know, when you want to go to prayer or you want to go into fasting, you already have the list of prayer points that you pray about every week, every month. However you do your fasting, you already have the routine about what you pray about. You know that, right? That's not what I'm saying. That doesn't make you a Christian. Inviting God to an issue means that you don't have to have a long list. Bring one issue to God and make sure that you settle it with God. Hallelujah. How many of us know that there are times that we pray about something, you know that this prayer is already answered after you prayed it? Have you been in that situation before?
Yes.
You pray that prayer, even by the time you feel it, you know that today this prayer has been answered. So what am I saying is this: God that you have, bring it to the issue, not all the issues. Hey, he bites me. Hey, God. God. Hey, God. He said this. Hey, God. So, by the time you go to prayer, you have this long list of all your friends, all your enemies. You want provisions. You want fruit basket. You want a promotion. You want to have free victory over your enemy. You have everything on the list. So, by the time you pray, even if you have 24 hours to pray, you have everything to mention in that 24 hours. That is a waste of time. Because you are still going to say it tomorrow. You are going to say it next tomorrow. God has already known you with your list. What makes a difference is, bring that to your issue. That one, Yoruba people, I love the way they say, give it back at the entire lesson. Yoruba people say, ko takuti olorun lorun. Okay? Do you know, if my wife didn't give me dinner yesterday, do you know? He smiles, man. Do you know? I'm not saying she didn't give me dinner. Okay? But what I'm trying to say is this. You don't really know if my smile is genuine. You don't know. You are the one that knows the pain that you are passing through. That thing that is really, really causing pain is the issue I want you to bring to God. If I am a son of God, if I am a man of God, there has to be a solution to this issue. You hear me?
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
People that don't understand you, they will say you are arrogant, you are proud. But if you are indeed a child of God, everybody cannot march on you and get away with it. Every issue cannot be tossing your life ups and down. Enemy must not be having its way. The problem must not be the one that is controlling your joy. In the morning you are happy, in the afternoon you are sad, in the night you are depressed. In the morning you are happy again, in the morning, afternoon you are sad, in the night you are depressed. A roller coaster lifestyle. This is not what makes you a Christian. Stand up, child of God. Make the best of God that you have. Somebody say, I am not going to allow that anymore. And you will not allow that anymore in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
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 You are in control. Somebody say, I'm in control. I am in control. I am in control. I am in control. I am in control.